Hi, Holy Frog here. I wanted to make a video concerning some of the issues a Paladin tank face in raids, especially in the main tanking role. Now, I imagine most guilds that have a Paladin tank as part of their raid team are fine letting them tank trash, adds, or bosses such as Lucifron and Gehennas, where the adds are being killed first and the boss is left to last. But they may be hesitant to let the Paladin tank bosses with DPS want to start dealing damage right away. Now these bosses can actually be a problem for Paladin tanks. We lack a taunt ability in case DPS over aggro, and we also don't have the same ability to deal threat up front like a warrior does. The warrior can just pre-Q a heroic strike while running in, and following it up with an immediate shield slam or bloodthirst. Druids arguably also have some additional risks to them, as their maul ability is tied to their 2.5 second swing timer, meaning if they miss their first maul, or it gets parried or dodged, the DPS may over aggro and pull. In case of druids, however, this is often solved by using a manual crowd pummeler for the 50% attack speed increase, pre-halting themselves before the pull, or by casting Moonfire or Wrath before shifting to bear form. And if things really go wrong, they can also just taunt. Note that taunt is mostly a thing in Molten Core. In later raids, the majority of bosses there is straight up not tauntable. And because of that, the advantage that taunt brings to the later raids is severely diminished. So let's talk a little bit about Paladin threat in a main tanking role. Now, it's no secret that a Paladin's threat output is lower than the other tanks. The one thing that we Paladins do have going for us in Classic is the Greater Blessing of Kings, and I will explain this in a moment. But for now, let's just talk about the other abilities. Here's the spell power scaling for our different abilities. As you can see, the scaling of these abilities with spell power is relatively low, so adding spell power to your gear, while it will increase the threat output you do, it's not a magic fix for our threat issues. The secondary issue with our threat output is that most of our abilities are tied to long cooldowns. Holy Shield has a 10 second cooldown, and this is not really a problem in itself since Holy Shield requires you to block to deal threat, so getting more block chance on your gear such as the Drillbore Disc, 2% blocking jump, Stylene's impeding scarab, or the couple block value or block chance items from Sulgurub, like the ring and the cloak, they will all increase the amount of Holy Shield procs you get from each Holy Shield cast. Holy Shield charges against multiple enemies, you typically don't really need any block value on your gear for this, because tanking multiple mobs gives you a high chance of using up all the Holy Shield charges anyway. It's a different story for your other abilities, however. Judgment is on a 10 second cooldown, 8 seconds if talented. This means apart from getting spell power, there is nothing you can really do that will let you use this ability more often. Your Consecration ability is also on an 8 second cooldown, but this ability can be kept up indefinitely, as it also lasts 8 seconds as well. In the case of Consecration, you are limited by the amount of mana you got available to you, as the spell is quite expensive. It should be noted that Consecration is taking up a debuff slot, so you may want to be careful with how much you use this ability, especially if your guild is taking debuff slots seriously and have agreed upon what should be up on the boss and not. Exorcism, it also has a 15 second cooldown, but this ability is not something that will see a lot of use until next Rammus. So, Paladin abilities being on long cooldowns is, in my view, the primary problem behind Paladin threat that warriors and druid tanks do not have to deal with. As warriors keep raiding, they will have more gear options available to them. They will be stacking hit and crit on their gear, and they will increase the amount of attack power they have on their gear as well. The thing with warriors, and especially druids, is their threat modifier from defensive stance and bear form applies to all damage done. So increasing the physical damage output of these classes also increases their threat directly. This is not that different from how spell power increases Paladin tank's threat, but there is one noteworthy difference. Dealing more damage generates more rage. This not only means that these tanks will be doing more threat from their abilities as they get better gear, it also lets them use their abilities more often. So the only real cap to the threat of these classes is how many global cooldowns they have available to them. So now let's talk about what a Paladin can do to keep up with these two classes. When Classic released, it was discovered that Righteous Fury not only increases the threat from holy attacks like the tooltip says, but rather it increases the threat of all holy school spells. This was confirmed by Blizzard as being the way Righteous Fury used to operate back in 2006, which means its current mechanics are here to stay. Greater Blessings are considered holy school spells, and the way buffs work in Classic is that they generate threat equal to the level the spell was learned. The reason you want to use Greater Blessing of Kings is that, like most Greater Blessings, it's learned at level 60, and Kings also cost the least amount of mana out of all the Greater Blessings. It should be noted that Greater Blessing of Wisdom for some reason do not give any threat, so you never want to use this. So now for some numbers. Greater Blessing of Kings generates 60 threat per player buffed, since it's learned at level 60. With Righteous Fury active, this is increased to 114 threat per cast. To maximize the effect of this blessing, you want to cast Greater Blessing of Kings on whichever class you have the most of in the raid. In my own raid with 8 mages, this means each cast of Greater Blessing of Kings is going to give me a total of 912 threat per global cooldown. This effectively lets us keep up with Warrior and Druid tanks on threat in the current content. The issue with Greater Blessing of Kings for threat, however, is that the target you buff has to be on the threat table of the boss for the threat to count, which makes it somewhat unreliable during the first few seconds of a boss fight when DPS is still moving into positions and they have not been casting any spells or attacking the boss yet. Now with this in mind, what I like to do during the pull is to judge the boss with Seal of Righteousness as soon as I can. Now most of the time this spell won't resist and you will get a pretty solid amount of upfront threat on the boss. It can, however, resist because anything above level 60, any monster above level 60, have level-based resistances even to the Holy School. So because of this, I advise you to tell your DPS to hold back a second or two to make sure you establish solid threat. And if your judgment does resist, you need to call that out so the DPS can hold back a couple more seconds. I also immediately drop a Consecration on the boss as soon as the boss is where I want it to be. Consecration costs a lot of mana, but it also does about 100 threat per second, depending on your spell power. If you time it right, you can also cast your first Holy Shield once you enter combat. This Holy Shield is also a buff, it will provide you with a small amount of threat. I have not extensively tested exactly how much, but Holy Shield rank 3 is learned at level 60, so I believe it should cost 114 threat with Righteous Fury active. That's the same as casting Great Blessing of Kings on a single target. With these things together, you should have enough threat that you can comfortably move the boss to where it needs to be. And at this point, you want to use every available global cooldown casting Great Blessing of Kings. Just make sure you keep your Holy Shield active on every cooldown. This is done not only for the added threat when you block, but also because your block chance will be increased by 30%, and you're much less likely to receive crushing blows from the boss. Keep your seals active as well, and which seal you want to be using depends a little on the overall DPS of the raid and the length of the encounter. Because Greater Blessing of Kings is such a large portion of your threat, you may want to make sure you conserve your resources so that you can keep casting it for as much of the encounter as possible. Now, once Judgment is back up from being on cooldown, I typically judge Wisdom on the boss if I feel I have a solid amount of threat, and then I recast either Seal of Righteousness or Seal of Wisdom. From my experience so far in Molten Core though, no buffs last long enough that I have needed Seal of Wisdom to sustain my mana, and so I can just keep using Righteousness for the added holy damage. Seal of Righteousness can also trigger my Flurry Axe, so I will get a few extra attacks as well with the added chance of restoring mana through Judgment of Wisdom. One more thing to note is that using Judgment of Righteousness may not always be something you want to do. In my current gear with an Arcane Elixir up, it deals an average 270 holy damage. With Righteous Fury up, that means its Judgment of Righteousness is about 500 threat for one global cooldown. And it's costing a global cooldown because you need to recast your seal once you judge. So this is actually less than one Greater Blessing of Kings with 5 or more players in the raid. So what you can do is you can just drop Judgment from your rotation and you just spend a global casting a Greater Blessing of Kings instead for more threat. Judging on cooldown also means that you have to recast your current seal afterwards, and this brings the total mana cost up to 250 with Firefire Benediction from the Retribution Tree. This means that the threat per mana is way worse than Greater Blessing of Kings. I still use Judgment, however, while tanking, because my threat output is already quite a lot higher than the rest of my raid in Molten Core, and it adds a little bit of extra damage to contribute towards the speed of the kill. As DPS start getting more gear, however, and your kill times are lowered, you may want to just stop judging entirely and instead spend the global on Greater Blessing of Kings. Later on in the game, however, once you start getting a high enough spell power, it should be noted that at some point, I have not done the math on this, I don't know exactly when it will happen, but at some point the damage from Judgment is going to surpass Greater Kings again. Because Greater Kings, again remember, it only scales with the number of players you buff. So it will generate a static amount of threat, which means at some point, at some level of spell power, Judgment of Righteousness will do more threat. So the last thing I want to talk about is Golem Mag the Incinerator. And this is a good example of a fight where Paladin threat actually suffers quite a bit. And you may ask why, and it's because Golem Mag has two adds. And this same thing applies to every boss in the game that has adds that players are put in combat with. Because of how great the Blessing of Kings work, it means that the threat is being split between all the mobs you're currently in combat with. And because you're in combat with three mobs here, that means Blessing of Kings is doing one third of the threat I would expect it to do. How you compensate for this is you just need to spend every global you have on Kings, same as before. Your threat output will be a bit lower, which means it would be advisable for fights like this to stack some additional spell power if you can afford that while still staying alive. I did not on this fight, however, I'm just in my regular tank gear that I use for everything else. 400 defense. I used the Flurry Axe because the Flurry Axe will still give you quite a lot of mana regeneration. And as you can see in this fight, I actually made a mistake here. I did not put up Judgment of Wisdom early on in the fight, and this leads my mana regeneration to suffer the further out in the fight you go. This is actually one of the challenges you face as a Paladin, is learning when to put up your Judgment of Wisdom and when not to. Because your mana bar is finite, it means you have a finite number of casts you can do before you run out of mana. And with Judgment of Wisdom up, you will basically extend the time you're able to cast spells before you run out of mana. But Judgment of Wisdom will never be enough to sustain your mana bar the entire fight, which means you need to adjust your ability usage to the amount of mana you have. So because this fight was so short, I didn't really have any issues holding aggro, but you definitely want to make sure your Judgment of Wisdom is up as early as possible in the fight, as this will overall allow you to have more available mana for Greater Blessing of Kings, for Holy Shield, for recasting seals and other spells. If push comes to show and you really need mana, you could always ask for an innovate as well. And innovate, even though you're a Paladin and you don't have that much spirit, the innovate is still gonna give you a huge chunk of mana back, which will allow you to continue casting. And so to end this video, I want to talk about one more item that you can use on bosses like this to greatly increase the amount of time you can cast Blessing of Kings. And this item is the Burst of Knowledge. This drops in Blackrock Depths and it reduces the mana cost of your spells by 100 per cast. Now since Greater Blessing of Kings costs 150 mana, this effectively reduces the mana cost by 2/3. This allows you to get multiple additional Greater Blessing of Kings casts off, which means you're extending the time you're able to cast spells before you run out of mana. So I think this is a great trinket. It does have a 15-minute cooldown, however, so you can't use it on every fight. But if there are fights where you know that you're gonna struggle with mana, then this is a great trinket to use. As a nice little bonus, it also has 12 passive spell power, so once the effect runs out, you're still gonna get some benefit from having the trinket equipped in one of your trinket slots. So, I hope you liked this video. Let me know how your Paladin tanking adventures go, and if you thought this was useful, leave a like and comment on the video.